Hello everyone, I am Dr. Kinna Shah from GCRI Ahmedabad, presenting my views on the facio-maxillary surgery or injuries management by submental intubation. Facio-maxillary anesthesia is a special situation when surgeon is sharing the airway with us. The main causes of 90% cause of facio-maxillary injuries are due to the road traffic accident, assault, sports, gunshot wound or occupational injury, benign or malignant tumor at the face may be the other reasons. What defines the facio-maxillary surgery is a pan-facial trauma as in the road traffic accident, craniofacial surgery, individual fracture management, nasal tumor, extensive cancer surgery and facial trauma. Facio-maxillary trauma is a crucial and a complex one associated with the cervical spine injury. It's mainly present with the altered airway anatomy, which makes the anesthetist to difficulty in a mass ventilation and difficulty in endotracheal intubation. The risk of regurgitations, aspiration, and bleeding may present as these are the mainly the emergency procedures. Facio-maxillary surgery is start with the stabilization of the patient with the radiological test is done together, and the same when the surgery is planned, the other injured organs or other injured limb has to be operated same way with the facio-maxillary part. The specific situations like posterior inferior displacement of the fractured maxilla blocks the nasopharyngeal airway, or a bilateral fracture of anterior mandible that causes a blocked oropharynx. Associated with that, the fracture or teeth, bone fragments, vomiting, blood, secretions, foreign body like denture, debris, and hemorrhage may there in the oro or nasal cavity with altered anatomy and the soft tissue swelling, edema is being present. The detection of such situations and facilitation of the proper airway management is a major part of a patient outcome. Because the 50% of the patients of these injuries have multi-site trauma and high complication rate may occur in intraoperative and postoperative period, which may exceed to 20%. The most experienced person should perform a difficult task airway management as probably the better anesthetist. It's a team management, or maybe the surgeon, anesthetist, trauma specialist, radiologist, and the critical space specialist makes the teamwork effort and makes the successful patient management. Timely decisions, skillful airway management is must. Patient may have altered sensorium, is the Glasgow's coma scale less than 9, then the use of sedative or analgesic has to be in a precocious way. Oxygen saturation may be 90% with the spontaneous breathing, then the pre-oxygenation start with the emergency room also. The radiological investigation like 3D CT, which shows the extent and composition of the airway injury or other part of injury with the soft tissue edema demarcation and restricted neck movement can be done or not being explained. The airway management is being start at the emergency room, then the esophageal intubation, esophageal tear, alteration in heart rate or new onset cardiac dysrhythmia and cardiac arrest may happen at that time. So the anesthesiologist must be aware of it. The first thing should be done as a nasal gastric tube insertion, cervical spine immobilization, hypovolemic shock treatment, coagulation defects should be detected and then is treated, packing of the oral or nasal cavity, ligation or embolization of the arterial part at the bleeding part, pre-oxygenation in the form of non-drilling mask, when intubation plan, the DL scope, fiber optic intubating LMA, or a VL scope must be prepared. It should be ready to use. No excuses can be given. Manual inline stabilization has to be prepared. And oral intubation with rapid sequence intubation with or without the Celix maneuver must be planned. Orotracheal intubation is not suitable for a mandibular fracture surgery because the assessing the dental relationship or the fixed occlusion test While nasal intubation is contraindicated in nasoorbital ethmoid or a fracture at the base of the skull. So anesthetic is a much more in dilemma what to do, what type of airway management is done. In this presentation, I am exploring the submental intubation technique for such situations. So what is submental intubation and how, what, where can be applied, that I can explain. In a simple way, the conversion of the oral AT tube to submental area by passing through the tunnel made through the anterior floor of the mouth. It allows a free intraoperative access to oral cavity and nasal cavity as an alternative tracheostomy for a short-term postoperative control of the airways. Pioneer of this technique is Altamir in 1986, which done for an intermedullary wiring to prevent the tracheostomy. Pros and cons of the two options available for airway management in facial maxillary anesthesia, that is tracheostomy, that is most widely used, we are knowing it, tracheal stenosis, PO fistula, hemorrhage, surgical emphysema complication can occur. And while the submental intubation is definitely an underused technique or is technique to learn, but the complication associated with it is hypertrophic scar, orocutaneous fistula, infection, bleeding, and there. The ventilatory outreach time is much more minimal with the submental intubation than for the tracheostomy. So we prefer it, the submental intubation instead of the tracheostomy. Whichever the technique is being done, then extubation should be deferred until the normal anatomy or the edema should subside. Prior to oral intubation, the AT tube connector of a reinforced AT tube should be detached or reattached from the tube. This is the most crucial part. If it is not been detached or is impacted, then it is cut, the tube connector has been cut away. And the same appropriate size tube or Fortex tube connector should be reattached to it and make it visible or not, then it has to be there. When orotracheal intubation is being performed by whichever the method is visible, it should be done 2 weeks in PICS, bilateral air entry check. Then approximately 3 cm lateral to the mandibular midline, a submental horizontal incision of 1.5 cm was placed a finger breadth below the mandibular inferior border. It's been done by the surgeon. A orocutaneous tunnel with a blunt dissection towards the mouth floor was performed. Then the long stout artery forceps was then introduced through the tunnel from the outside to widen it. It is disconnected. Its connector is removed, ventilator is detached, and the AT tube is grasped by the tip of the artery forceps, which was forced from outside. AT tube is being pulled out through that artery forceps and followed by the again the pilot balloon also. The connector is been attached, and the circuit is being attached to the ventilator. The AT tube again repositioned by examining the oral cavity, the bilateral air entry check, and the stay suture is applied silk with the outside and the fix it as shown in the photo. The alternative equipment for making a submental tunnel wider is the nasal speculum with the long flanges. Percutaneous dilatation tracheostomy kit can be used. We had used a blue connection of ICD tubing, a PVC cylinder of a disposable 10cc syringe can be used, silicone tube, nylon tubes, surgical glove finger can be used to making a submental tunnel wire. This is a short and sweet procedure. Incision sizes of less than 2 cm. Both the tubes can be successfully pulled out through the tunnel. And this is a picture of a submental incision, which is after 1 month surgery. Such a noticeable and such a invisible scar is being then promising with against the tracheostomy tube scar. The complication as of the submental intubation for the wound is a hypertrophic scar, infection, bleeding, or mucosal can be there. And the technically problem with the endotracheal or pilot tube change is being by the tube damage, right main stem intubation, or a accidental extubation can be possible. So be careful. At our GCRI, we are using a submental intubation for a large nasal tumor or a mandibular maxillary tumor, where the much large area of exposure is being needed for a radical dissections. In that pictures, there are no oral or nasal tube, but the case was done with the submental intubation, which is under the drap. These are again the photo of a large orbital tumors where the exposure is there. Submental tube is under the drap and this case is maintained with that. Thank you for the attending. Thank you. Thank you, everybody.